Hello, this is my third video on creating circular progress bars, and today we'll consider how to add a noise effect to the border of the field area. Links to the previous two videos I will leave in the description. There will also be a link to a text lesson made from these videos. And for those who support me on Patreon, I will leave a reference to the finished material. Let's see what has changed since last time. As you can see, the holes block is now called sections. The variable x of holes is called section borders sharpness. Function mf holes, in fact, has not changed. All logic from the base color block has remained unchanged, but now it's in the mf base color function. The same goes for the background color block. The logic remained unchanged, but moved to the function mfbgColor. The circle block has not changed, and in the angle block, the variable xpangle is now called color area borders sharpness. And another logical variable used border noise was edit. It's responsible for enabling and disabling noise at the border. Let's move on to the mfangle function. A new block border noise was added here, and this switch. Let's open the border noise function. It consists of three main blocks. The border noise area block indicates the area in which the noise appears. Noise area creates a linear gradient that changed from 0 to 1 in this area. And also defines a painted area that is not affected by noise, base area. The border noise area parameter determines how much of the area will be occupied by noise. The offset border noise area parameter allows us to shift the noise region relative to the border of the field region. If the value is equal to 0, then in the noise region it shifts forward to the unfilled region, and if the value is 1, then the noise area is shifted back. The function mf border noise area offset we will consider a little later. Let's move on to the noise block. It's responsible for adjusting the noise. The cosine gradient block turns a linear gradient into a piece of a sine wave, which allows for smoother transitions around 0 and 1. The parameter border noise value offset allows us to adjust the color intensity in the noise area. The noise texture block allows us to select a noise texture and scale it. And the noise power block allows us to change the noise contrast and gradient in the noise area. The parameter border noise gradient power is responsible for the contrast. the max body noise value parameter. Is responsible for the color gradient in the noise area. The combine area block combines the filled and distilled region and the noise region. Let's move on to the MF body noise area offset function. This function shifts the noise region relative to the body of the filled region and allows us to enable or disable corrections in the region of 0 and 1. Corrections affect the size of the noise area. Now we see the notation used in this function. Parameter p is responsible for the filled area. Parameter a determines the size of the noise area. And parameter d determines how much the noise region enters the filled region. That is how much the noise region is offset relative to the boundary. The area without noise block is responsible for the filled area, in which there is no noise. If the fixed noise near unit switch is on, then when approaching unity, the size of this area will increase due to a decrease in the area occupied by noise. If the switch is off, there will be no change. The next block is responsible for the resizing the region near zero. If the fixed noise near zero switch is on, then that part of the noise region that is in the unfilled region will decrease as it approaches zero. If the switch is off, there will be no change. The last block is responsible for the resizing of the noise region around unity. If the fixed noise near unit switch is on, then that part of the noise region that is in the filled area will decrease when approaching unity. If the switch is off, no change will occur. Let's see how these switches affect. Let's fill the scale by 95%. Now, as you can see, this does not greatly affect. Let's shift our noise area. Move it inside the filled area and set percent value to 0.99. As you can see, the scale is almost completely filled and visually everything is true. Now, if we turn off this modifier, we get the feeling that we have 5% left to fill the scale. The fixed noise near zero switch works similarly. Let's set some small value. Now everything is more or less logical. But if we move the noise region forward, then you see how the picture has changed. In principle, now it's not far from reality. And if we turn off fixed noise near zero, then the area will move forward quite noticeably. And the difference is already becoming very large. Let's turn on this switch, and now the noise is located approximately in the place where it should be. And that's all for today. Like it if you like the video. Subscribe to the channel. See you in the next video.